Hello, Bumpy McSquiggums here, and I am continuing once again with my Let's Play of Xenonauts. This is episode 12, and I believe I have my rookies on their way to deal with the aliens. Though, I'm starting to wonder if this is a good idea. Who do I have? Because I know I had one or two hurt people. How many do I actually... Oh. Okay, so I'm sending five people in this... Nope, not gonna do it. Sorry. You just lost your right to actually do battle, so you get to return to base. Sorry, you guys are not quite ready for combat. So we're gonna wait it out a little bit. We'll advance time, and then of course we're going to try very, very, very heartily to... Ooh, that's terrible. To make it to the crash site in time. Really? Alright, so at this point we are going to send the bump pod with our main force at the alien wreckage, the crash site, if you will, and we are of course going to do it during daylight hours. And there we have it, daylight mission, and it's time to go. So look at that, within a minute or so we're already into combat with the aliens with a full contingent of troops and, well, some hopeful level ups and junk and stuff, I guess I could say. Alright, so let's do our typical exit strategy here out of the ship and see what we find. Because there are times that things don't go exactly according to plan. I'm hoping that nobody's like, boop, pops around the corner and caps this dude in the face, because that would make me very, 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 very unhappy and, well, quite sad, actually. A little beyond unhappy, I would say. Alright, so I think I'm going to move this shieldy guy over here. Good old MDB, the face-tanking man that he is. Move him that direction, and we'll move Rita out in this direction. And... we are going to have to take a look inside the building, but not quite yet. I'm going to move over here, maybe in between. I'll do a crouch there. I'm a little bit safer. I think I'll send a sniper out this direction. And our better sniper out in this direction. So, that leaves good old Pete Holmes to figure out exactly what it is he's going to be bringing to the table. Right now he's going to be bringing awkwardness and giant rocket launching abilities. Alright, so let's end our turn. Everyone's moved not super far, but a decent amount. And we shall see what the aliens decide to do with the knowledge that they have. Thankfully that our knowledge is not that great, because nothing bad has happened. However, we are blocked by the civvy right in front of us there. Well, I suppose he's like a security guard or a police officer, maybe not a full civilian, which is fine. Alright, well, we'll move these guys into the position, up and around, and he's blocking my shotgunner. I'm not a big fan of how that actually worked out for me. That's okay. We'll move over here, take a look, nothing. Move over here, take a look, still nothing. Here, take a look, take a knee. We will pop out to the butt end of the car, and we'll peek that way, nothing. We'll peek this way, nothing. Where are the aliens? The aliens are hiding from us, apparently. Keep the sniper on the corner. Going to send him in behind. And Pete Holmes, I guess, can move in this general direction. Oh, I don't like that. Nope. Oh, and there's an alien right there. Well, darn it. Can we lob a grenade over the wall, I wonder? Do we have the TUs to do it at all? We do not. Alright, so Pete Holmes, good luck. You're gonna need it. Yeah, there's no way. Alright, well, let's hope Pete Holmes is okay. They only decided to move closer. And he somehow magically knew we were behind the wall there. It's mighty impressive. I mean, Pete Holmes is the easy kill, and he went after something else, so... I'll take it. I will take it. Well, you know what? There we go. Get Jordan Robinson a little love there. Let him get in there and do some work. I like it. I'm slightly terrified to be out and exposed like this. So, oh, that's... Oh, gosh. Oh, that was unpleasant. Well, I don't suppose Petey can do anything amazing. Maybe. How much does he need for a gas grenade? Ooh. 47, and he's at... Give it a shot. Even if she does get passed out, it's fine. Well, I wouldn't say fine. I guess that's a... That is a misnomer, but it's okay. Whatever. Mistakes were made. They usually are. I get a little over-greedy, over-aggressive, and death usually ensues. Usually it's the aliens, but in this case it's kind of my own troops. It's a little sad. It is. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. Shouldn't have gone that route. Decided that, you know what, I can probably manage this. My guys are pretty tanky. Got a shield unit, and then, of course, right next to the shield, and pain and agony. Yep, not good. Definitely not good. Alright, Neboru, you get to go... Oops. Get to go chill up with an MDB, and you guys hopefully can make something happen in that area. I think I'm going to go into the building with him. Alright, let's see what happens. I think the pass out happened. We'll see. Sound like something happened to one of the aliens. What they need to do now is they need to make Xenonauts Zombie Edition and have alien zombies coming after you. That would be you falling asleep. That's fine. Cat naps are okay. We will not begrudge you a nap. A little disappointed that you're not going to be part of our assault force, but things could be worse. Alright, well, Petey, my friend. Let's get you set up with the correct rocketry that you actually need. Let's get you over here. And crouched. You can come forward and crouch as well. Let's see what the shieldy peeps discover. Take a look in there. There is an open door. And there's a police officer over here. Interesting. And I'm seeing no alien activity whatsoever. So that's kind of good, I guess. No alien activity is good alien activity, right? There's no aliens in the building that I see. And we've pretty much scanned most of the outer reaches here. It's possible, though, every time I say that, bad stuff happens. It is possible there's no aliens left, but I am not going to bank on that at all. I'm pretty sure that's a terrible idea. So, aha! There it is. See? I just have to say that phrase, and then aliens come out of everywhere. That is the phrase to bring them out. Thankfully not in a very good position this time, nor very effectively, I might add. We'll go with 32. Sad. And we'll go with 31. Bam! In your face! 3, and down he goes. Sweet, sweet, nice. And yeah, I like that. Alright. Over this way. I don't think there's anything left. Nope, it seems pretty clear. Even with our better armor, we're still not indestructible, so I will have to make sure my guys aren't too stupidly over-aggressive. I can deal with mildly over-aggressive, somewhat stupid, but when you go a little overboard, it tends to really, really cost you. Now, let's see here. Oh. I'm very tempted to try something. And I still may, but not just yet. Alright. Everyone's moved. Yep, everyone has done something. Let's hope the aliens aren't too over-aggressive themselves, because that could cost me quite badly. Come on. Come on. In my solo playthrough, I did shoot down a Corvette, and I found the alien officer. Sadly, my shotgunner was too effective, and the guy walked out and got overwatch shot right in his face, and, well, shotgun to the face, especially a laser shotgun to the face, not pleasant. He did not enjoy it. We'll leave it at that. Please don't stand on the fallen body of your compatriot. Thank you. And you might as well heal him up. There you go. Good work. Alright. The rest of you, come. You have work to do. Work. Come on. Come on. All of you need to get over here. Alright. The only downside that I see really over the long course of things is snipers being amazing, but I generally don't armor them. That might be a mistake in the long run because they die really easy without armor, the troops, so getting even the first wave, the first tier of armor, helps quite a bit, and then once you start getting wolf armor and the later armors, it gets even better. I just heard a door open. I'm hoping it's not to the alien craft, though I have to admit it did not sound like an alien. Oh my gosh. Really? She's back! Ladies and gentlemen, she is back! Holy cow, what in the world just happened? Aredith has risen. Well, that is new. I would not have guessed that. So apparently if you heal your fallen compatriots, they come back? Well, I guess, I don't know. That was pretty sweet. I mean, I know it was a knockout gas thing, but still. I'll take it. I mean, that was big surprise, and a very nice big surprise. I like that a lot. Alright. You, sir, get your sniper rifle back. You get into position there. You have a sniper rifle as well. You get into position. You must get in position from behind. And I think that's good. We're gonna breach in this next turn and hope everything works out. And aliens are really thinking about what's happening inside there. Okay, yikes. There's four. That's unpleasant. Alright, if we land that. Central freeze pressed. Nope. No, only the one. Alright. Well, what if we land it over here? I'm gonna get two suppressed. Oh, he got shot in the back by his ally. Nice. Nice. Alright, this might be terrible. Let's give it a shot. Oh, yeah. That was not good. Definitely not some of my better work. Well, my people were tired, so might as well let them take a nap. I mean, I don't see why that's an issue. I'd really like to run through the gas, but I think that's a bad idea. So, let's take a shot. Ooh, we hit him, nice. Back up, do some... Okay, that did nothing. Impressive. Okay, crouch. How's that? Alright, and then Nicole Hernandez. You can take 5% and bam, down he goes. Sweet, sweet, nice. You've got a shot over there, though. I don't know that I necessarily want to do that. This seems like a terrible idea as well, so we're going to try it anyway because, well, why not? And it made it. Very nice. All right. So everyone's going to back up, and we're going to do the pastime deal. We'll let our sleeping beauties sleep, and then we'll wait for the gas to dissipate as we normally do, and then we'll go in and get further in and do some damage, even though Nate Boru looks very angry and unhappy. I think he probably has a unibrow. He has to wax that thing. I don't know. Maybe pluck it? Maybe he shaves it. Maybe he's trying to grow it out and he's going to start braiding it or something. Who knows? Who knows? That would be weird to have a unibrow braid. I would have to say that would be one of the strangest things I've ever seen. And no, I don't want to ever see it. So please, if you have links of this, do not send it to me because I will not watch it. I will have nightmares then. And, well, I don't like nightmares. Nightmares are bad, generally speaking. And in this particular instance, it would be bad. All right. We're going to stick him back up against the door. We're going to wait. Probably one turn. I might be able to go inside in this turn. At least open the door, see what's still standing, if anything. Looks like all the aliens are catnapping, which is fantastic. We can hop that. I'm going to open the door and go right in. And who do I want behind me? Let's bring him along, shall we? Jordan, come. Let us go. Let us slaughter. By the way, Jordan Robinson is my nephew. What? I know. Doing shout-outs all around. Alright, once the aliens decide that there's nothing left for them to do... Oh, look at this. Pleasant. And down he goes. And Jordan, my friend, it is your turn to lay down... the pew 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 and done. Alright, so minor injuries, 8-9 days, a little bit rougher, but still not too bad. They are the shield units, they face tank projectiles and plasma and all that, you know, fun stuff. It's fine, Nate Boru has managed to make it to the major leagues. Jordan's not quite there yet, though he's managed to finally drop 5 ETs in combat, as well as Nicole Hernandez. She got 10, so very nice. Very nicely done. 73,000 monies and all sorts of good things for us. Nobody died at all on our side, and everyone on their side did. Alright, so that worked out rather nicely. I want to take a look at our research. Our research is done. We're producing our last precision laser, which should be done, like, yeah. I'll say almost instantaneously. I'd actually want to wait till they get back to base before I do that. And there they are. And we are going to bring up the snippers. The snippers. There they are. And we're going to drop this. I've never had to use that. And we're going to go to lasers. And we're going to go to precision. And they seem like they are going to do quite a bit more damage. And with 6 shots, that's a total of 12. For now, it should be fine. Can I afford to place another one in? They have grown more powerful and slightly stronger over time. So let's hope. We'll set the equipment as default. And we'll equip the default. And yes, they can actually hold all of that. That is excellent news. Wolf armor and jackal armor is not done, which means now we can start producing the wolf battle armor, which will be... a very, very nice upgrade for us. It will be fantastical. I'm pretty sure that I did bring extra soldiers in the last episode. I'm like 100% sure I did this. There we go. We're going to go over to DeBase because DeBase needs the Nooch soldiers to do the work. So they have 5 and 2 that are wounded still. And what are they missing? Sniper... they're missing a shield person. Okay. So we have no shield person. That's a sniper if I've ever seen one. Or a heavy. No, not with a low strength. We'll go with a shield. Shield people don't need to have amazing stuff. Alright, so the bump drop. Bogdan Laskin, who we're going to have to change his name. He needs to become 11 Lavender Gooms. There we go. Good old Private Lavender Gooms. Alright, you, sir, are going to change your role into a shield unit. Alright, excellent. I know you are missing equipment. I am well aware of these things, these facts. You have no extra armor for you, sir, and boom. So that's the double shield, and we'll double check one final time to make sure we have two snipers. We do. We have a rocketeer that likes to hurt himself. And we have an assault, two shields now, yes, riflemen and heavy weapons. Alright, so we've got it all covered. We really, really need something happening at this point because we are... There we go. Ooh, it's a medium one. Alright, so here we go. Here we go, guys. We're going to send out the entire squadron of aircraft. Apparently I can only send out three. Whatever. Should work. We're going to launch. And we are going to hope that we are able to take it down. Auto-resolve 100% victory. It is a Corvette. And I think we're going to go long in this episode, guys. I'll say, it's been about 22-ish minutes or so. So I would like to get this done now, so I think we're going to do it. We're going to roll out, and we're going to make it happen. Before we do that, we're going to take a look at any of the Jackal armor done yet. Or, sorry, the Wolf Battle armor done yet? No. We need a little bit of time to pass anyhow. And that should be more than enough. And anything? Nope, no wolf armor. Alright. So, let's send out our people. And this should be the next step in our research progress as well. So, excited. I'm a little trepidatious, you know. I'm a little scared. But, we're going to engage. And here comes our first battle with the Corvettes, guys. So there's the potential of having these weird insectoid alien things. Don't know what they're called, I don't remember, I apologize for that. This will be the first mission where the alien officer is present, as it says right there. And it'll be identifiable by the headgear. So a helmet, essentially, will showcase who the alien officer is. We are up against a wall on this side, I like that very much. And we are indeed in a corner, and that is quite alright. Alright, I'm going to try to play this one by the book, but last time I said that I think I ended up shooting a rocket into the back of somebody's head and killing them. Local forces didn't really want to throw a parade to me, or for the Xenonauts on that particular day, but... You know, the press really never got word of it because I just blamed it on aliens, you know? They did like a planetary bombardment. I don't know. I got nothing. I've got absolutely nothing. I'm almost tempted to send my guys in one just giant sweeping pattern. Now, breaching the Corvette, I do not have a great way of doing this yet, so you guys will see me struggle. I've done it a few times and been relatively successful, but... I definitely don't have it down to a science. I am not as good at breaching that as I am other things. I've never actually got to try out my laser sniper rifle yet. It always seemed to be something I pushed back because of monetary confines. So we're going to get to check that out a little bit. I'm excited for that. We will take knees everywhere, and we will go this direction. And I'm scared. And nothing bad has happened yet, which is always a good sign. Take a knee with her. I'm going to roll up back behind this stuff. And we'll get Nicole Hernandez. I guess we can just put her right behind... there we go. And we are all moved out and into relatively decent positions, so we'll see how this transpires. That sounded loud and not good. That sounded different, too. I'm going to assume that was probably one of the insectoid alien-type creatures. Now, I'm very hesitant to even sort of move out at this point. Oh, there we go. It's our first alien. I'll take a shot at him. Totally miss, of course. He's gonna fire back. Move my sniper into position. 5% chance, and down he goes. Definitely loving the new sniper rifle. Alright. He'll crouch. Going to move Mutanot forward and hope that there's not an insectoid just sitting there waiting for us, because that would be awful. In fact, I'm very tempted to move out and scout with him, but I'm not going to, so we're going to crouch. Ugh. Scary stuff, guys. Scary stuff. Alright. And with these fellows, we're going to go slow. We're going to try to keep ourselves covered as much as we can. I think I'm even going to send Pete Holmes over here, because we're going to be near the ship. That's kind of dangerous, so we'll take a knee, we'll take another knee, and we're going to end our turn and see what happens. So far, nothing. So far, nothing. Okay, I don't know if that's good or bad. I want to assume it's probably okay. Take a look that way. Nope, just farmer shooty pants over there. Alright, go that direction with him. Set our sniper up over here. Crouched, and then we'll get... This just does not seem like a good idea at all. Alright, let's go there. I'm going to take a look with Mutanot. There is an alien right there. Which I'm very, very tempted to shoot at, but I don't think it's a good idea, so I'm going to move up here. Now I'm going to shoot at him. Fire back. We're going to deflect with our shield because we're bosses like that. Take a look over there. I see nothing coming, which means very little. Mutanot is going to move in to take a shot. Not enough. There we go. I was getting a little concerned. That should have been enough, but you know, it is what it is. There. We get Jordan Robinson in behind, and we get Pete Holmes lingering over here. Alright, at this point, we have made all of our moves that we want to make. It looks that way. We'll end our turn and see what happens. Oh, that didn't sound pleasant, but at least it's not on screen, which means probably wasn't one of my troops. Which is a good thing. It is getting pretty warm these days here. I gotta tell you, it's gonna be soon that I'm gonna have to kick on our very noisy air conditioner in this room. Oh, hello. I don't think he enjoyed getting shot in the butt very much. Can't say I blame him. I don't think I'd enjoy it either. Alright, we're gonna move over here and hopefully take him out. Nope. No such luck. Alright, looks like I'm gonna crouch. And then, can I take a shot with a sniper? It looks like I can. 83% chance. Totally missed. Great. And she's exposed, and she has no armor. This is not good. Actually, that... It's really bad. It's not just not good, it's really not good. Why am I having a... Oh, there we go. Like, why am I having a hard time maneuvering where I want to maneuver? Alright. I guess we can get Pete Holmes coming over in this general direction, this region over here. Face that way. Should be fine facing this way. Alright, let's see what horrible thing is going to happen. Oh gosh, one of those creatures. Oh boy. Oh no! What in the heck is that? That is a new type of weapon I haven't seen before. Well, that can't be good. We are going to have to... Oh no. Oh, come on, MDB. Stop being that coward. No, don't run that way! Oh god. Well, that happened. Of all the places to run, that was where you chose. Still standing. Holy crap. Alright, well, he's dead. He's 100% dead. The question is, are we going to survive? You know, maybe he's not dead. Maybe he's not dead yet. Maybe if we're really, really lucky, he'll survive. I wonder what kind of horrible idea this is. This seems like a really, really bad idea. Like a really, 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 really bad idea. Yeah, no, I'm not gonna do it. Trust me, I want to. A lot, but it just seems like it's such a bad idea that I can't justify doing it for any reason. Alright, well, let's get Petey up here. Nicole Hernandez up. Hopefully MDB is really, really ridiculously lucky and he doesn't die. I'm doubting it, but it's possible. I mean, there's a potential chance that the knockout gas might work and he lives. Though, again, highly doubtful. That was not a good place to run, man. When you run to safety, not into horrible awfulness, okay? Future reference. Future reference. Alright. Well, he did survive. Ooh, we made something catch on fire, and we knocked out the horrible creature. It doesn't tell me what the thing is, does it? No. Alright, where did he run from? He ran from over there. I'll admit, that was a scary thing. That guy had some sort of like weird shotgun-esque type deal himself, so... I can totally understand where you're coming from, man, but... Seriously, don't run into more danger. General rule, learn it. Really bad. Alright, well, let's get the heck out of here. That could have gone so much worse than it actually did, and I am pretty happy that it didn't go bad. Alright, there is an alien somewhere that we see in the house on the upper floor. Huh. Well, that could be problematic. Alright, well, what if I get behind him? I don't really have a shot. I don't know that those are windows either. Alright, well... Darn it. I don't know what to do at this point. I'm kind of hesitant to move forward, so... We're gonna take this slow. Maybe I don't have to take it as slow as I thought I might. Let's get Redith over here out of the way, so I don't have to worry about death. And let's do a little, Pete Holmes landscaping. What say you? Oh, beautiful. Gotta love Pete Holmes landscaping, ladies and gentlemen. Pete Holmes landscaping is phenomenal. Alright. Well, that worked. Not sure that it should have, but that worked. So, we still have several nasty guys in there that we're going to have to deal with at some point, but things are going fairly well outside. Gotta say that much, at least. Oh, no. I'm hearing ship noises. I don't like ship noises. Ship noises make me nervous. Rita, continue moving around. Stop walking through tall grass where it freaks me out, making me think something horrible is about to happen. We're gonna roll with the concept that maybe we're done out here. And we're gonna start moving our way back. I really, really want to capture the alien officer this time. We already probably captured that other creature, so that's a good thing. Don't know that we necessarily need him for much of anything anymore. Maybe he can lob a grenade? I got nothing. Grenade! I'm assuming that's going to be like the best thing that he can do at this point for our cause. Grenade chuckage. Alright, we do have a shield left. Rita, and she is in a very stupid position right now. It's fine. It's fine. Alright, so let's move back in. And see, my chair is sinking, in case you guys are wondering. I am getting shorter and lower and lower and lower and lower and quieter. No, just lower in general. Height-wise. There may be stuff up there, but if there is, we'll deal with it when we get to that. When we get to that point, after we clear out the alien ship, it's very possible too, and I'm pretty sure this happened to me my first time I shut down a Corvette, that the alien officer actually died in the crash and he wasn't available for me to murder or capture. Or both. I suppose both works. So, that being said, that's a potential reality that we face here as well. Alright, good old Petey. I have a plan. It's not a good plan. Most of my stuff usually isn't a very good plan. But, at least I have plans. If those plans do work, oh, there's stuff happening in the ship still. I can hear movement. The aliens are like, where are all our forward scouts? What's going on? We heard gunfire and some laser pew-pew phaser fire and such, but no check back. No telepathic comlinks in. This might be a ridiculously bad idea, I'm just saying right now. I'm just calling it as I see it. But we're going to lob one of our rockets in there on the next turn. And it's probably going to be terrible. So, just saying. Just saying. I don't know the coverage that my rocket will get. But, oh, there's another door. I forgot about that. Poo. Do I even dare go in there with him? I can still do this. That's not a good idea. There's the commander. Alright. Now, the question. Everybody's mind. Can you do it, Petey? Can you do it, my friend? Man up! And run like a scared little girl. Or just crouch, because you can't run. And hope that he passes out. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I just did that. That was not a good idea. That was so not a good idea. Whatever, I did it. I did it, and I don't regret it. Yet. That was not a good idea. I would never advise doing that. That was such a bad idea. Hang in there, Petey. Oh, you're a boss. Oh my gosh. Sweet, sweet, nice. All right, Pete. Run for your simple little life. Get out of there. Oh my gosh, that was so awesome. I'm sorry guys, I am just enamored with how that actually played out. Alright, can we lob one of these? Oh, we can. Sweet. Please don't miss. Please don't be stupid. Oh. Go, Redith. Get some of that poison cloudage going up in that place. Yeah. Alright, so we're going to end our turn again. Did we get him? Probably not. But I'm hoping. We're going to have to peek at some point. I am nervous. Oh, he's down! Yes! Now all we do is survive the rest of the mission. Not the easiest thing to do, but yeah, there's a potential chance that that might actually happen. Let's hope. Alright guys, a little bit of a distraction there. Sorry for the big delay, but I probably edited it all out. You guys have no idea. I'm amazing. I'm not amazing, but who knows. Alright, so we're going to crouch with him, take a knee. Who do I want to send in? Jordan. Jordan, you sound like a good lad to go in. I'll send you in, my friend. And we'll end our turn. And we'll see what happens. Alright, more aliens getting waylaid by my gaseous cloud, or gaseous, noxious cloud. We'll go with that. And, ooh, a little pistol fire, a little shot in the butt. Oh, man, he got 3 reactionary shots off. That's pretty impressive. And he is stuck in the cloud as well. So we can take him down. I'm feeling pretty good about this. I'm feeling really good about this. This is pretty awesome. Oh, down he goes. Is that it? Are we victorious? Oh, we're not. Not yet. There's no telling where the aliens are still remaining, so we're going to have to scoot forward just a little. Kind of do a sweep left. Looks like there's a dead alien there. A sweep right. There's definitely a dead alien there. I think I'm going to move here. And take a knee. I'm going to move him up. Have him take a knee as well. And we'll move Mutanot up as well, and once again take a knee. Alright, so there should be aliens back in this area, but usually they come rushing forward, so I'm not 100% certain what's happening right now as far as the aliens go. You get to stay out. Oh, we should probably start moving some of these people in. You did a great job, Pete Holmes. Proud of you, my friend. Craziest thing I've ever done. That was great. It worked out, and we're gonna end our turn. And let's see, do the aliens come forth, or do we miss one of the outskirt aliens? Are we gonna have to like scour the entire map now? I don't know. I'm gonna move up with my shieldy unit and see. I'm also gonna take a peek over here with Mutanot. There's no one in that general region, so I'm gonna move over. Oh, no, that's not how I wanted you to run, you doofus. Alright, hop over the thing. Go stand on the dead alien body. And take a knee. You're gonna move forward. And you're gonna take a knee. Move you here. You're gonna face forward as well. Take a knee. I think Nicole Hernandez is in a kind of an ungood position. An unoptimal position, I suppose. Alright. Take a look. See what happens. Oh, he came out. Oh, we missed. Oh. Oh, come on. Ow, that was painful. Mutanot literally face tanked point blank. That was rough. But you know what? He's still there. He's still standing. And he's like, yeah, so what? I got shot in the face twice. Guess what? I hurt more. And he's right. He does. He does hurt way more. Alright, well, let's try to heal up a little from that. That was unpleasant. Thankfully, he's got a lot of hit points. And thankfully, people don't suffer from, like, wounds. Oh, there's still some nasty stuff going on in this place. Alright, well, let's do this. That's it. That's it. Victory. Yeah. All right. So Mutanot's injured for 10 days for getting shot twice point blank in the face with a plasma rifle. Unpleasant, but fine. Jordan managed to get himself promoted up to major. He didn't get much in the stat gain department, though, which is really kind of sad. But it's okay. Nicole Hernandez got some decent stats. We have Nate Boru getting some good stats as well. Redith getting some really good stats. She's only injured for 7 days. MDB kind of got owned. He's wounded for 13, so he won't be able to go on another mission for a few days at least. Pete Holmes got some TUs, which is good. And let's take a look. He's got the Crimson Heart for getting owned. And he's been on 10 combat missions. Go MDB. What? And 10 extraterrestrials. 10 ETs brought down by me, Captain Bumpy McSquiggums. Alright, so we've got the Corvette Data Core. We got a Reaper. We got a Reaper Corpse. We got a Civilian Officer. Alien Assault Plasma. Alien Heavy Plasma. A bunch of Alien Alloys. Some Elenium. And a bunch of other stuff. And we came out with, which is actually sad because the other ones we actually got more for, but 67,700 monies. And we have a lot to research now, which is sweet, sweet nice. Now, Alien Electronics. I believe it's going to help us get new, it says right there, this may help us get new, develop new vehicles and aircrafts. So, I think I want to get a new aircraft. I think I want to retire the Condors. I just need to get enough funding to do so, and I gotta make sure I can start. I don't know. I'm not sure what to do at this point. I think I honestly think I need a third base, which is risky because a third base is gonna be expensive. In addition to that, it's going to take some time to do. There's no guarantee we're gonna have the thing, the coverage there that we need, both fighters and everything else. It's something. And then we have the directional thrusters, which I believe gives us a better dropship. It does. There we go. And then, of course, the alien officer interrogation brings us up closer to defeating them. So we have quite a few things we can do. I personally think I'm going to go with the alien electronics. It's probably not the right choice, but it's the one I'm going to make. And at this point, guys, I'm going to break off the episode. So thank you guys for joining me. Hopefully you enjoyed. And I'll catch you tomorrow with the next installment of Xenonauts. It should be episode 13. Until then, my name's Bumpy McSquiggums, and I will see you later. Alright, let's see what horrible thing is going to happen. Oh gosh, one of those creatures. Oh boy. Oh no! What in the heck is that? That is a new type of weapon I haven't seen before. Well, that can't be good. We are going to have to... Oh no. Oh, come on, MDB. Stop being a coward. No, don't run that way! Oh god. Well, that happened. Of all the places to run, that was where you chose. Still standing. Holy crap. Alright, well, he's dead. He's 100% dead. The question is, are we going to survive? You know, maybe he's not dead. Maybe he's not dead yet. Maybe if we're really, really lucky, he'll survive. I wonder what kind of horrible idea this is. This seems like a really, really bad idea. Like a really, 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 really bad idea. Yeah, no, I'm not gonna do it. Trust me, I want to. A lot, but it just seems like it's such a bad idea that I can't justify doing it for any reason. Alright, well, let's get Petey up here. Let's go Nicole Hernandez up. Hopefully MDB is really, really ridiculously lucky. And he doesn't die. I'm doubting it, but it's possible. I mean, there's a potential chance that the knockout gas might work. And he lives. Though, again, highly doubtful. That was not a good place to run, man. When you run to safety, not into horrible awfulness. Okay? Future reference. Future reference. Alright. Well, he did survive. Ooh, we made something catch on fire, and we knocked out the horrible creature. It doesn't tell me what the thing is, does it? No. Alright, where did he run from? He ran from over there. I'll admit, that was a scary thing. That guy had some sort of like weird shotgun-esque type deal himself, so I can totally understand where you're coming from, man, but seriously, don't run into more danger. General rule, learn it. Really bad. Alright, well, let's get the heck out of here. That could have gone so much worse than it actually did, and I am pretty happy that it didn't go bad. Alright, there is an alien somewhere that we see in the house on the upper floor. Huh. Well, that could be problematic. Alright, well, what if I get behind him? I don't really have a shot. I don't know that those are windows either. Alright, well, darn it. I don't know what to do at this point. I'm kinda hesitant to move forward, so we're gonna take this slow. Maybe I don't have to take it as slow as I thought I might. Let's get Redith over here out of the way so I don't have to worry about death. And let's do a little Pete Holmes landscaping. What say you? Oh, beautiful. Gotta love Pete Holmes landscaping, ladies and gentlemen. Pete Holmes landscaping is phenomenal. All right. Well, that worked. Not sure that it should have, but that worked. So we still have several nasty guys in there that we're going to have to deal with at some point, but things are going fairly well outside. Gotta say that much, at least. Oh no, I'm hearing ship noises. I don't like ship noises. Ship noises make me nervous. Redith, continue moving around. Stop walking through tall grass where it freaks me out, making me think something horrible is about to happen. We're gonna roll with the concept that maybe we're done out here. And we're gonna start moving our way back. I really, really want to capture the alien officer this time. We already probably captured that other creature, so that's a good thing. Don't know that we necessarily need him for much of anything anymore. Maybe he can lob a grenade? I got nothing. Grenade! I'm assuming that's going to be like the best thing that he can do at this point for our cause. Grenade chuckage. Alright, we do have a shield left. Redith, and she is in a very stupid position right now. It's fine. It's fine. Alright, so let's move back in. And see, my chair is sinking, in case you guys are wondering. I am getting shorter and lower and lower and lower and lower and quieter. No, just lower in general. Height-wise. There may be stuff up there, but if there is, we'll deal with it when we get to that. When we get to that point, after we clear out the alien ship. It's very possible, too, and I'm pretty sure this happened to me my first time I shut down a Corvette, that the alien officer actually died in the crash and he wasn't available for me to murder or capture. Or both. I suppose both works. So, that being said, that's a potential reality that we face here as well. Alright, good old Petey. I have a plan. It's not a good plan. Most of my stuff usually isn't a very good plan. But, at least I have plans. If those plans do work, oh, there's stuff happening in the ship still. I can hear movement. The aliens are like, Where are all our forward scouts? What's going on? We heard gunfire and some laser pew-pew phaser fire and such, but... no check back. No telepathic comlinks in. This might be a ridiculously bad idea, I'm just saying right now. I'm just calling it as I see it. But we're going to lob one of our rockets in there on the next turn. Mission where the alien officer is present, as it says right there. And it'll be identifiable by the headgear. So a helmet, essentially, will showcase who the alien officer is. We are up against a wall on this side. I like that very much. And we are indeed in a corner. And that is quite alright. Alright, I'm going to try to play this one by the book. But last time I said that, I think I ended up shooting a rocket into the back of somebody's head and killing them. Local forces didn't really want to throw a parade to me, or for the Xenonauts on that particular day. But, you know, the press really never got word of it because I just blamed it on aliens, you know? They did like a planetary bombardment. I don't know. I got nothing. I've got absolutely nothing. I'm almost tempted to send my guys in one just giant sweeping pattern. Now, breaching the Corvette, I do not have a great way of doing this yet, so... You guys will see me struggle. I've done it a few times and been relatively successful, but I definitely don't have it down to a science. I am not as good at breaching that as I am other things. I've never actually got to try out my laser sniper rifle yet. It always seemed to be something I pushed back because of monetary confines, so... We're gonna get to check that out a little bit. I'm excited for that. We will take knees everywhere, and we will go this direction. And I'm scared. And nothing bad has happened yet, which is always a good sign. Take a knee with her. I'm going to roll up back behind this stuff. And we'll get Nicole Hernandez. I guess we can just put her right behind. There we go. And we are all moved out and into relatively decent positions, so we'll see how this transpires. That sounded loud and not good. That sounded different, too. I'm going to assume that was probably one of the insectoid alien-type creatures. Now, I'm very hesitant to even sort of move out at this point. Oh, there we go. It's our first alien. Take a shot at him. Totally miss, of course. He's gonna fire back. Move my sniper into position. 5% chance, and down he goes. Definitely loving the new sniper rifle. Alright. He'll crouch. Going to move Mutanot forward and hope that there's not an insectoid just sitting there waiting for us, because that would be awful. In fact, I'm very tempted to move out and scout with him, but I'm not going to, so we're going to crouch. Ugh. Scary stuff, guys. Scary stuff. Alright. And with these fellows, we're going to go slow. We're going to try to keep ourselves covered as much as we can. I think I'm even going to send Pete Holmes over here, because we're going to be near the ship. That's kind of dangerous, so... We'll take a knee, we'll take another knee, and we're going to end our turn and see what happens. So far, nothing. So far, nothing. Okay, I don't know if that's good or bad. I want to assume it's probably okay. Take a look that way. Nope, just farmer shooty pants over there. Alright, go that direction with him. Set our sniper up over here. Crouched, and then we'll get... This just does not seem like a good idea at all. Alright, let's go there. I'm going to take a look with Mutanot. There is an alien right there. which I'm very, very tempted to shoot at, but I don't think it's a good idea, so I'm going to move up here. Now I'm going to shoot at him. Fire back. We're going to deflect with our shield because we're bosses like that. Take a look over there. I see nothing coming, which means very little. Xenonaut is going to move in to take a shot. Not enough. There we go. I was getting a little concerned. That should have been enough, but you know, it is what it is. Crouch there. We get Jordan Robinson in behind, and we get Pete Holmes lingering over here. Alright, at this point, we have made all of our moves that we want to make. It looks that way. We'll end our turn and see what happens. Oh, that didn't sound pleasant, but at least it's not on screen, which means probably wasn't one of my troops, which is a good thing. It is getting pretty warm these days here. I gotta tell you, it's gonna be soon that I'm gonna have to kick on our very noisy air conditioner in this room. Oh, hello. I don't think he enjoyed getting shot in the butt very much. Can't say I blame him. I don't think I'd enjoy it either. Alright, we're gonna move over here and hopefully take him out. Nope, no such luck. Alright, looks like I'm gonna crouch. And then, can I take a shot with a sniper? It looks like I can. 83% chance. Totally missed. Great. And she's exposed, and she has no armor. This is not good. Actually, that... Eh. It's really bad. It's not just not good. It's really not good. Why am I having a... Oh, there we go. Like, why am I having a hard time maneuvering where I want to maneuver? Alright. I guess we can get Pete Holmes coming over in this general direction, this region over here. Face that way. It should be fine facing this way. They didn't make Xenonauts Zombie Edition and have alien zombies coming after you. That would be you falling asleep. That's fine. Cat naps are okay. We will not begrudge you a nap. A little disappointed that you're not going to be part of our assault force, but things could be worse. Alright, well, Petey, my friend, let's get you set up with the correct rocketry that you actually need. Let's get you over here. And crouched. You can come forward and crouch as well. Let's see what the shieldy peeps discover. Take a look in there. There is an open door. And there's a police officer over here. Interesting. And I'm seeing no alien activity whatsoever. So that's kind of good, I guess. No alien activity is good alien activity, right? There's no aliens in the building that I see. And we've pretty much scanned most of the outer reaches here. It's possible, though, every time I say that, bad stuff happens. It is possible there's no aliens left, but I am not going to bank on that at all. I'm pretty sure that's a terrible idea. So, aha! There it is. See? I just have to say that phrase, and then aliens come out of everywhere. That is the phrase to bring them out. Thankfully not in a very good position this time, nor very effectively, I might add. go with 32. Sad. And we'll go with 31. Bam. In your face. 33, and down he goes. Sweet, sweet, nice. And yeah, I like that. Alright. Over this way. I don't think there's anything left. Nope, it seems pretty clear. Even with our better armor, we're still not indestructible, so I will have to make sure my guys aren't too stupidly over-aggressive. I can deal with mildly over-aggressive, somewhat stupid, but when you go a little overboard, it tends to really, really cost you. Now, let's see here. Nope. I'm very tempted to try something. And I still may, but not just yet. Alright. Everyone's moved. Yep, everyone has done something. Let's hope the aliens aren't too over-aggressive themselves, because that could cost me quite badly. Come on. Come on. In my solo playthrough, I did shoot down a Corvette, and I found the alien officer. Sadly, my shotgunner was too effective, and the guy walked out and got Overwatch shot right in his face, and, well, shotgun to the face, especially a laser shotgun to the face, not pleasant. He did not enjoy it. We'll leave it at that. Please don't stand on the fallen body of your compatriot. Thank you. And you might as well heal him up. There you go. Good work. Alright. The rest of you, come. You have work to do. Work. Come on. Come on. All of you need to get over here. Alright. The only downside that I see really over the long course of things is snipers being amazing, but I generally don't armor them. That might be a mistake in the long run because they die really easy without armor, the troops, so getting even the first wave, the first tier of armor, helps quite a bit, and then once you start getting wolf armor and the later armors, it gets even better. I just heard a door open. I'm hoping it's not to the alien craft, though I have to admit it did not sound like an alien. Oh my gosh. Really? She's back! Ladies and gentlemen, she is back! Holy cow, what in the world just happened? Aredith has risen. Well, that is new. I would not have guessed that. So apparently if you heal your fallen compatriots, they come back? Well, I guess, I don't know. That was pretty sweet. I mean, I know it was a knockout gas thing, but still. I'll take it. I mean, that was big surprise, and a very nice big surprise. I like that a lot. Alright. You, sir, get your sniper rifle back. You get into position there. You have a sniper rifle as well. You get in position. You must get in position from behind. And I think that's good. We're going to breach in this next turn and hope everything works out. And aliens are really thinking about what's happening inside there. Okay, yikes. There's four. That's unpleasant. Alright, if we land that. Central three suppressed? Nope. No, only the one. Alright. Well, what if we land it over here? We get two suppressed. Oh, he got shot in the back by his ally. Nice. Nice. Alright, this might be terrible. Let's give it a shot. Oh, yeah. That was not good. Definitely not some of my better work. Well, my people were tired, so might as well let them take a nap. I mean, I don't see why that's an issue. I'd really like to run through the gas, but I think that's a bad idea. So, let's take a shot. Ooh, we hit him, nice. Back up, do some... Okay, that did nothing. Impressive. Hello, Bumpy McSquiggums here, and I am continuing once again with my Let's Play of Xenonauts. This is episode 12, and I believe I have my rookies on their way to deal with the aliens. Though, I'm starting to wonder if this is a good idea. Who do I have? Because I know I had one or two hurt people. How many do I actually... Oh. Okay, so I'm sending five people in this... Nope, not gonna do it. Sorry. You just lost your right to actually do battle, so you get to return to base. Sorry, you guys are not quite ready for combat. So we're gonna wait it out a little bit. We'll advance time, and then of course we're going to try very, very, very heartily to... Ooh, that's terrible. To make it to the crash site in time. Really? Alright, so at this point we are going to send the bump pod with our main force at the alien wreckage, the crash site, if you will, and we are of course going to do it during daylight hours. And there we have it. Daylight mission, and it's time to go. So look at that. Within a minute or so, we're already into combat with the aliens, with a full contingent of troops, and, well, some hopeful level ups and junk and stuff, I guess I could say. Alright, so let's do our typical exit strategy here out of the ship and see what we find. Because there are times that things don't go exactly according to plan. I'm hoping that nobody's like, boop, pops around the corner and caps this dude in the face, because that would make me very, 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 very unhappy and, well, quite sad, actually. A little beyond unhappy, I would say. Alright, so I think I'm going to move this shieldy guy over here. Good old MDB, the face-tanking man that he is. Move him that direction, and we'll move Redith out in this direction. And... we are going to have to take a look inside the building, but not quite yet. I'm gonna move over here, maybe in between. I'll do a crouch there. I'm a little bit safer. I think I'll send a sniper out this direction. And our better sniper out in this direction. So, that leaves good old Pete Holmes to figure out exactly what it is he's going to be bringing to the table. Right now, he's going to be bringing awkwardness and giant rocket launching abilities. Alright, so let's end our turn. Everyone's moved not super far, but a decent amount. And we shall see what the aliens decide to do with the knowledge that they have. Thankfully that our knowledge is not that great, because nothing bad has happened. However, we are blocked by the civvy right in front of us there. Well, I suppose he's like a security guard or a police officer, maybe not a full civilian, which is fine. Alright, well, we'll move these guys into the position, up and around, and he's blocking my shotgunner. I'm not a big fan of how that actually worked out for me. That's okay. We'll move over here, take a look, nothing. Move over here, take a look, still nothing. Here, take a look, take a knee. We will pop out to the butt end of the car, and we'll peek that way, nothing. We'll peek this way, nothing. Where are the aliens? The aliens are hiding from us, apparently. Keep the sniper on the corner. Going to send him in behind. And Pete Holmes, I guess, can move in this general direction. Oh, I don't like that. Nope. Oh, and there's an alien right there. Well, darn it. Can we lob a grenade over the wall, I wonder? Do we have the TUs to do it at all? We do not. Alright, so Pete Holmes, good luck. You're gonna need it. Yeah, there's no way. Alright, well, let's hope Pete Holmes is okay. They only decided to move closer. And he somehow magically knew we were behind the wall there. It's mighty impressive. I mean, Pete Holmes is the easy kill, and he went after something else, so... I'll take it. I will take it. Well, you know what? There we go. Get Jordan Robinson a little love there. Let him get in there and do some work. I like it. I'm slightly terrified to be out and exposed like this. So, oh, that's... Oh, gosh. Oh, that was unpleasant. Well, I don't suppose Petey can do anything amazing. Maybe. How much does he need for a gas grenade? Ooh. 47, and he's at... Give it a shot. Even if she does get passed out, it's fine. Well, I wouldn't say fine. I guess that's a... That is a misnomer, but it's okay. Whatever. Mistakes were made. They usually are. I get a little over-greedy, over-aggressive, and death usually ensues. Usually it's the aliens, but in this case it's kind of my own troops. It's a little sad. It is. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Shouldn't have gone that route. Decided that, you know what, I can probably manage this. My guys are pretty tanky. Got a shield unit, and then of course, right next to the shield, and pain and agony. Yep, not good. Definitely not good. All right, Neboru, you get to go. Oops. Get to go chill up with the MDB, and you guys hopefully can make something happen in that area. I think I'm going to go into the building with him. Alright, let's see what happens. I think the pass out happened. We'll see. Sound like something happened to one of the aliens. What they need to do now is... Okay, crouch. How's that? Alright, and then Nicole Hernandez. You can take 5% and bam, down he goes. Sweet, sweet, nice. You've got a shot over there, though I don't know that I necessarily want to do that. This seems like a terrible idea as well, so we're going to try it anyway because, well, why not? And it made it. Very nice. Alright, so everyone's going to back up and we're going to do the pastime deal. We'll let our sleeping beauties sleep, and then we'll wait for the gas to dissipate as we normally do, and then we'll go in and get further in and do some damage, even though Neboru looks very angry and unhappy. I think he probably has a unibrow. He has to wax that thing. I don't know. Maybe pluck it? Maybe he shaves it. Maybe he's trying to grow it out and he's going to start braiding it or something. Who knows? Who knows? That would be weird to have a unibrow braid. I would have to say that would be one of the strangest things I've ever seen. And no, I don't want to ever see it, so please, if you have links of this, do not send it to me, because I will not watch it. I will have nightmares then, and, well, I don't like nightmares. Nightmares are bad, generally speaking, and, in this particular instance, it would be bad. Alright, so we're going to stick him back up against the door. We're going to wait probably one turn. I might be able to go inside in this turn, at least open the door, see what's still standing, if anything. Looks like all the aliens are catnapping, which is fantastic. We can hop that, we can open the door, and go right in. And who do I want behind me? Let's bring him along, shall we? Jordan, come. Let us go. Let us slaughter. By the way, Jordan Robinson, it's It's my nephew. What? I know. Doing shout-outs all around. Alright, once the aliens decide that there's nothing left for them to do... Oh, look at this. Pleasant. And down he goes. And Jordan, my friend, it is your turn to lay down the pew-pew-pew-pew and done. Alright, so minor injuries, 8-9 days, a little bit rougher, but still not too bad. They are the shield units. They face tank projectiles and plasma and all that, you know, fun stuff. It's fine. Nate Boru has managed to make it to the major leagues. Jordan's not quite there yet, though he's managed to finally drop 5 ETs in combat, as well as Nicole Hernandez. But she got 10, so very nice. Very nicely done. 73,000 monies and all sorts of good things for us. Nobody died at all on our side, and everyone on their side did. Alright, so that worked out rather nicely. I want to take a look at our research. Our research is done. We're producing our last precision laser, which should be done, I'll say almost instantaneously. I'd actually want to wait till they get back to base before I do that. And there they are, and we are going to bring up the snippers. The snippers, there they are. And we're going to drop this. I've never had to use that. And we're going to go to lasers, and we're going to go to precision. And they seem like they are going to do quite a bit more damage. And with 6 shots, that's a total of 12. For now, it should be fine. Can I afford to place another one in? They have grown more powerful and slightly stronger over time. So let's hope. We'll set the equipment as default. And we'll equip the default. And yes, they can actually hold all of that. That is excellent news. Wolf armor and jackal armor is not done, which means now we can start producing the wolf battle armor, which will be a very, very nice upgrade for us. It will be fantastical. I'm pretty sure that I did bring extra soldiers in the last episode. I'm 100% sure I did this. There we go. We're going to go over to DeBase because DeBase needs the new soldiers to do the work. So they have 5 and 2 that are wounded still. And what are they missing? Sniper... They're missing a shield person. Okay. So we have no shield person. That's a sniper if I've ever seen one. Or a heavy. No, not with a low strength. We'll go with a shield. Shield people don't need to have amazing stuff. Alright, so the bump drop. Bogdan Laskin, who we're going to have to change his name. He needs to become 11 Lavender Gooms. There we go. Good old Private Lavender Gooms. Alright, you, sir, are going to change your role into a shield unit. Alright, excellent. I know you are missing equipment. I am well aware of these things, these facts. You have no extra armor for you, sir, and boom. So that's the double shield, and we'll double check one final time to make sure we have 2 snipers. We do. We have a rocketeer that likes to hurt himself. And we have an assault, 2 shields now, yes, riflemen and heavy weapons. Alright, so we've got it all covered. We really, really need something happening at this point because we are... There we go. Ooh, it's a medium one. Alright, so here we go. Here we go, guys. We're going to send out the entire squadron of aircraft. Apparently I can only send out 3. Whatever. Should work. We're going to launch. And we are going to hope that we are able to take it down. Auto-resolve 100% victory. It is a Corvette. And I think we're going to go long in this episode, guys. I'll say it's been about 22-ish minutes or so. So I would like to get this done now, so I think we're going to do it. We're going to roll out, and we're going to make it happen. Before we do that, we're going to take a look at any of the jackal armor done yet. Or, sorry, the wolf battle armor done yet? No? We need a little bit of time to pass anyhow. And that should be more than enough. And anything? Anything? Nope, no wolf armor. Alright. So, let's send out our people. And this should be the next step in our research progress as well. So, excited. I'm a little trepidatious, you know, I'm a little scared. But we're gonna engage, and here comes our first battle with the corvettes, guys. So there's the potential of having these weird insectoid alien things. Don't know what they're called, I don't remember, I apologize for that. This will be the first